Today's lesson is all about stocks. A stock is simply water simmered with bones. The meat left over on the bones adds flavor to the water, while the bones and the connective tissue break down and add body to the liquid in the form of gelatin. Stocks are the foundation for soups and sauces. They also add endless amounts of flavor when used as a substitute for water. Whenever you're cooking grains or braising meat, here are some of the tools needed for making stock. You'll need a stock pot, water, some chicken wings, legs, bits and pieces, and a mirepoix of carrots, celery, and onion. So we have about 5 pounds of chicken. And the smaller the pieces of chicken connected to the bones, the better. I see the backs here have a little bit of fat. I like to take off as much of the fat as possible prior to making the stock. And you see all of this red stuff here? This is parts of internal organs. You want to remove all of that too, and any bloody bits. So pick this out and then wash the chicken very well. Now, there are important rules to remember when making a stock. A good stock starts with good ingredients. Your goal when making stock is to transfer all the flavor from those ingredients to the cooking liquid itself. So let me wash this. Right into the stock pot. And you see, if you use butcher paper, parchment paper, cleanup is at a minimum. So you put your chicken in and water to cover. Bring this to a boil. And as it comes to a boil, you're going to see that some chicken fat arises, and you want to skim that off using a strainer like this or a ladle like this. These square ladles are phenomenal. And have a container for the fat. I'm going to cut up our mirepoix. Use twice as much onion as celery and carrot. And these can be cut into quarters. The onions, 2 onions, and 2 carrots. And just cut these into chunks. And don't forget, leave the celery leaves on. Now bring the liquid to a boil and then immediately turn it down and keep everything submerged at all times. The reason that we use taller pots for most stocks is that there's less surface to evaporate. And always remember to simmer stock so that the impurities in the fat don't get emulsified back into the liquid as they would if the stock were boiling away. So now skim the chicken fat off the top. Again, you can choose your tool. I use this skimmer first because it takes very little moisture away. It drips all through, but the scum stays on the strainer. And you keep doing this during cooking time. You can see already that there is quite a bit of chicken fat accumulating on the top. So no matter how much fat you removed, there's still a lot under the skin of chicken. And all of that will be taken away. Let's see. And it's mostly fat. After that first skimming, add all your vegetables. And we call these the aromatics. And don't overload chicken stock with vegetables because you don't want to take away from that great, rich chicken taste. And some peppercorns, 1 teaspoon of black peppercorns, 1 dried bay leaf. I always add 2. And I'm not adding any salt at this time. The chicken stock recipe, this one, is an example of a white stock. It's the simplest stock to make. Raw bones and aromatics covered with water, gently simmered, to yield a very pure, clean flavored stock with a light color. Now for a really light stock, cook this for 1.5 to 2 hours. For a more intensely flavored stock, 3 to 4 hours. I'm going to cook this one for about 3 hours today. I want it to have a rich, full flavor. So look at the color of the stock. And I am passing the stock by ladling it from the pan to a cheesecloth-lined strainer. And just gently do this. Get as much stock out of here as possible. And what's happening is that a very pretty stock is accumulating in the bottom of the pan. So what a simple procedure, and you have the best chicken stock you've ever tasted. So much better than opening a can. Now, of course, you're going to strain all of this into here, ultimately, but look at that beautiful stock. Now, whatever you accumulate in the pan, just let it cool to room temperature, chill it, and then we're going to skim off the fat. So here we have chilled stock. It's already become gelatinous. And gelatin gives stock its body. It's produced when that connective tissue in the meat breaks down during the simmering process. And if prepared correctly, your stock should gel when chilled. Now with the edge of a sharp spoon, just scrape off the remaining schmaltz or chicken fat and discard. But this is a pretty clear, delicious looking stock. And it is very jellied, which makes me very, very thrilled, because it means we did our job right. So this is what it looks like. And you can just scoop this out and store in quart containers or pint containers like that in your freezer. You can use this stock immediately or store in the refrigerator for maybe up to 3 days. If longer than that, I would suggest putting it into your freezer. What you're going to get between 2 and 3 quarts of ultra delicious homemade stock. Now make sure that you label your containers clearly and with a date. So on a rainy weekend that you just happen to be at home, make yourself some stocks and get ready to do a lot more cooking with an emboldened liquid. I'm just cutting up vegetables because I wanted to show you another way to cook chicken stock, which is in the pressure cooker, which cuts the time down by 2/3 at least. And a pressure cooker like this, with a top like that, is a special cooking pot with an airtight lid, which locks, and it has a valve system to regulate internal pressure. And because steam builds up inside the pressurized pot, food cooks at a very high temperature, reducing the cooking time. That's why this method is quite ideal for making long cooking things like stocks. We'll start with the chicken because it has to come up to a boil. Backs, wing tips, wings, legs, whatever, small pieces of chicken, better. And this is, again, 5 pounds of chicken washed. And it looks good. Cover with 10 cups of water, because it's not going to cook as long and won't evaporate, as opposed to the 16 cups of water that we cooked with in the stock pot method. So bring this to a boil, and you're going to skim off all the scum, the vegetables cut into approximately 1-inch pieces. You want them to add as much flavor as possible while they're under pressure. And the same, bay leaf, peppercorns, very, very similar. So now pressure cookers reduce cooking time without destroying the food's nutritional value. The steaming, the pressure steaming, draws gelatin out of the bones more quickly. And that's what we really want. We want a gelatinous stock as clear as possible and as flavorful as possible. So the stock is just coming to a boil, and of course, remove any visible fat. Now add your vegetables. We'll reduce the heat after we put the top on and the pressure comes up. And your bay leaf, don't forget, and your peppercorns. Put the top on and wait for the pressure to come to high. So now reduce the heat just enough to maintain high pressure and cook for 30 minutes. So now the steam is almost down. To release that further, just push on this particular pressure cooker. This releases the steam. Before you open it, you really would like to release all the steam. So just wait for that blue button to completely retract. And then same procedure as with the stock pot stock. Pass the stock through a cheesecloth lined sieve into a large heat-proof measuring cup or bowl or pot, and let it come to room temperature, chill, and defat. So then you're gonna freeze it or use it. Now, because this stock was cooked in a short period of time, it's going to be a much lighter color stock, but it's going to have a actually deeper flavor because it was cooked under pressure. And if you get a little impatient waiting for the pressure to decline, as I have been waiting for it, you can actually run the pot under cool water and it will reduce the pressure much, much quicker. There, now we can just release. Mmm. Oh, smells so good. And you'll end up with more stock than in the stock pot method. There's very little evaporation. So now just strain. You can see the stock is a little bit lighter in color, a little yellower, and certainly extremely fragrant. I want you to see what you're getting. Very beautiful, light stock. Do not press on the solids. You don't want to release any more of the fat than it's been released already. But what a great stock, and what a time-saving device. And as we proceed with the show, making beef stock and vegetable stock, you can, of course, use the pressure cooker for either of those to save time.